Patriots, my name is Shay Davis.
And I'm Jenny Smith.
And you're watching the April and May edition of Patriot Vision. Despite the advances towards equality, gender stereotypes will always play a role in society. This is especially visible in the types of classes students take. I have more on why this is. Advances in gender equality have been happening rapidly for the last couple decades. However, there are still some blatantly obvious gender stereotypes prominent today, especially within the classroom. It's 2014 and still considered weird for a girl to be in a shop class or a guy to be in a fashion or parenting class. Senior Markwell Holman, the only guy currently in his fashion class, describes why deviating from the norm is still uncommon in today's society.
The stereotypes have to do with if you are a man taking a fashion class, you would necessarily have to be gay. Women in woodshop, I think people still think women should have feminine jobs, such as home economics type classes.
Family and consumer sciences teacher Christina Hawker expressed that parenting classes, though still dominantly female, should definitely be a required course for all students.
You know, I tell my students the very first day or two, you know, 98% of you in this building will become parents, so I can actually say that our subject applies to just about all of you, and it is quite relevant in your life.
There can be any number of reasons a boy takes a predominantly female class. These reasons range from,
I knew there was going to be nothing but girls in the class.
To,
because their girlfriend's taking it. I've had some boys that end up in there just because there was nothing else and that was their only option. And I've had some boys take it because they want to.
All depending on the person. Woodshop teacher Andy Shockley also expresses that stereotypes about females performing poorly in shop classes is a completely skewed state of mind.
Girls are more precise. They take their time. Boys are always in a hurry to get something done. Let's get on to the next project. Girls are more detailed oriented, and they seem to take their time and look at the little details.
Perhaps one day gender roles won't decide the types of classes a student should take. I'm Shay Davis, reporting for Patriot Vision.
The Mystica Al Fiedler Variety Show and Memorial Dinner is held annually for the benefit of students in forensics. Reporter Taylor Hickman goes in depth on this event.
It's Variety Show!
The variety show is typically an hour to an hour and a half long show. It's filled with all the short skits that the forensics team have wrote themselves. They're on a variety of topics. They could be anywhere from parodies of songs or just commentary on pop culture, making fun of it. Or it could just be just any goofy idea that we have.
Antoine Campbell tells his favorite part of the show.
I think my favorite part of the variety show was the skit that I had made, which was like a Soul Train skit. And that was pretty fun. I got to be the host.
Jagger Williams thinks the show was successful.
I think it was very good and we had a great turnout and everything.
The variety show was another success, and I'm Taylor Hickman signing off for THS Patriot Vision.
In case you didn't already know, Tech N9ne's music video for his song Fragile was recorded here at Truman. Reporters Brendan Chandler and Nolan Brooks have more on which areas were used to record and what the video was about.
So Brendan, did you know there was a Tech N9ne video shot right here at school?
Whoa! Stop. So you're telling me Tech 9 was right here?
Yeah. Let me take you on a tour of where all those shots were. This is another spot where it was shot. Let's bounce. So this is where a main, like, bigger part of the video is shot. Because the kid in the video plays the violin, and it's kind of his, like, release from the bullying that he gets in the video, and it helps him get through the day.
Sophomore Val Mathenia got the opportunity to be in the music video and says he really enjoyed it.
Being in the video was a good experience. I didn't get to meet Tech N9ne or anything, but it was really fun. It was a long day. I was there for about 8 hours just sitting around doing nothing. But in the end, it was really fun. Made some new friends with people. Got to talk with some people from all over the district and got to see myself in the video, although it's a very short amount of time. It's about the back of my head for maybe half a second, but I was there. It was fun, so.
Mr. Holm explains how the Tech N9ne video was set up.
A lot of times those companies will contact our facilities office about renting something. Then they'll send them our way. You know, I'm in charge of assigning rooms and time here in the building. And actually, Tech N9ne isn't the one that contacts you. In this case, it's the production company. I believe the name of the production company is Strange Music. You know, they went through the process of filling out building requests and rentals and insurance and all that kind of stuff, and ask him to reserve time, and you know, we make sure that there's not any conflicts with rooms or times or those kinds of things.
Another main scene in the music video in which the student was being bullied was recorded in Mr. Plaster's classroom. Mr. Plaster says he feels honored that his room was chosen.
93.3 interviewing me, hanging out with Tech N9ne tonight. I got enough pressure. In all seriousness, I think it was kind of cool that he chose to use the classroom for that. I don't know why they chose this one other than the lighting, but student bullying is something I do take pretty serious. I know there's a lot of kids in schools all throughout the United States that have social anxiety, trouble fitting in, and I hate the thought that, you know, school is a miserable place for those kids. And so anything that we can do to bring attention to this and allow kids to reach out to kids who, for the most part, keep to themselves, I think is a great message for our kids to learn. You know, I lecture my kids on doing that and focus the importance of befriending people. So I'm honored that he chose to do that in this classroom.
And thanks to
Strange Music
for permission for the use of their video.
I'm Brendan Chandler.
And I'm Nolan Brooks.
Signing off for THS Patriot Vision.
Let's bounce.
Distracted driving is one of the leading causes of teenage car accidents. I have more on the driving simulation held at Truman that attempts to prevent accidents.
It's the older person that you hit that hits a window or gets hit by the steering wheel. Their body just can't take that kind of impact.
In April, the seniors participated in a program that warned them about texting or drinking while driving.
It is actually an educational program that Cable Dynamo is sponsoring to really bring attention to the dangers of texting and driving.
Before they actually got to use the simulator, they were shown a video that told stories about what happened to people while they're either driving under the influence or while texting.
I don't really think the simulation was useful. I really liked the assembly because it really touched people and it was really the truth. But I don't think the simulation was a real, because I text and drive, I'm not going to lie, and it's not that hard if you know what you're doing. But I don't think the simulation of drunk driving and text and driving was really, it was more like a video game where you couldn't control. So I didn't really agree with the simulation.
The students actually got into a car to use the driving simulator. It either feel like they were under the influence or the guy running the driving simulator would be texting them on their phone.
This information, hopefully, this is the beginning of our process. We're doing one event at Truman High School, and then we did another one at Rockhurst High School yesterday. So our goal is to see how this is going to be, how it's going to be useful to diminish the rate of accidents in the country, and especially to save a life.
So Some people believe the simulator was more useful in preventing impaired driving, while others believe that the assembly was the most useful part of this event.
I learned more. Well, I think I learned more from the simulation because it puts you in that place. Like, it put me in the actual place of being in a simulation and shows me how easy it could be to die. I mean, like, seeing it in a video is showing probably how dumb somebody else is and the poor decisions that they made, but actually being in that, like, that place yourself is what it brings it home.
Make sure you drive safely so you can arrive alive. I'm Jenny Smith reporting for Patriot Vision.
Reporter Taylor Hickman provided us with a look back on the annual male beauty pageant, Mr. Patriot.
Viewers tell them what they liked most about Mr. Patriot.
It was really cool seeing all of my friends finally get to do this because previously it's always been people that weren't in my class, so I really made an effort to come and see them, and just, it's fun before graduation.
Judges tell them what they were looking for in Mr. Patriot.
I was looking for somebody that was gonna go up there and have fun and be comfortable and escape that horrible, awkward teenage high school feeling and just really rock it.
Richmond Jackson won Mr. Congeniality, Michael Alexander won runner-up, and Eric Reyes won Mr. Patriot.
It's a really big surprise. I definitely did not expect it at all. There were so many guys who did so many funny things, and I just did not expect this at all, so I'm really grateful.
I'm Taylor Hickman signing off for THS Patriot Vision.
Prom is a big part of high school and was enjoyed by many of the seniors this year. Porter Brendan Chandler has more on the story.
This year, Truman's prom was held at Arrowhead Stadium. Senior Hannah Black thought it was pretty good.
I really enjoyed prom and thought it was really cool that it was at Arrowhead. And it was a really nice space. And my favorite part of prom was probably just spending time with my friends and getting to dress up and just do something all together before we go our separate ways later.
Haley Osgood went as a sophomore and tells about her experience.
As a sophomore, going to prom, it gets me excited to go to prom my senior year.
Miss Linger is the one who organizes prom and has plans for where it's going to be next year.
It was a really nice evening. After 10 years of doing prom at Bartle Hall, this year we decided to go somewhere else, went to Arrowhead, and the facility was different and fantastic and classy. We didn't have to do a whole lot of decorations because the room was so nice, and the folks that were there really worked with us, and I think it was a really cool place, and we'll probably go back.
After all hard work and preparation, prom was a huge success. I'm Brendan Chandler signing off for THS Patriot Vision.
The school year is coming to an end and seniors are graduating. Here's reporters Melanie Steffen and Savannah Vineyard reporting on seniors' post-high school plans.
As the school year comes to an end, seniors say where they will attend for college.
I plan on attending Emporia State University after high school.
After high school, I plan on working all summer, saving up, getting ready for college, and then in the fall I'm going to UMKC, and I'll probably be there for 2 years, and then transferring to K-State.
Going to Blue River for 2 years, and then going to Graceland for 4.
I'm going to Blue River for 2 years, and then I'm going to UMKC.
I'm going to go to Georgia Southern University.
After high school, I'm going to go to Northwest Missouri State University, where I will be on the dance team.
Many seniors received scholarships.
Yeah, I did get a couple of scholarships. I got one through UMKC and then 3 foundation scholarships.
Yeah, one for basketball.
I did receive scholarships. I got an academic scholarship, and I will receive one for being on the dance team.
Yes, I did receive one scholarship. It was from NAACP. It was for $2,500 a year. Something simple, but it helps.
Seniors say what they're going to study in college.
I'm going to school for architectural engineering with a major in architecture and a minor in engineering.
Nursing.
Obviously play basketball, then study in communications and broadcasting, sports, and that.
I want to be a sports medicine physician.
Hopefully I will be a radio personality right after I get out of college. I will start an internship my senior year.
I want to get my secondary in teaching education and become a high school coach, football coach.
This is Melanie Steffen reporting for THS Patriot Vision.
Graduation is just around the corner. Reporter Jessica Armstrong has special send-off to our seniors.
As the school year comes to an end, students begin to realize how much they're going to miss the graduating seniors.
I'd like to give a senior shout-out to Molly Carroll. I love you, and I miss you, and I know you'll go far in life.
I'd like to give a senior shout-out to Zach Brett. I'm going to miss you, and good luck in college.
Hey, my senior shout-out goes to my sister, Cicely Mathenia. You are such an outgoing and amazing person, and I hope you know that. I obviously know I don't appreciate you a lot, or may not show it, but I love and care about you so much. I'm going to miss you. I mean, it's unbelievable how much I'm going to miss you. Everybody's going to miss you when you're gone. So I wish you the best of luck in college and your performing career, and we're always going to be waiting for you back home.
I'd like to give a senior shout out to Quentin Brown. It's not going to be the same without you next year. I'm really going to miss you, and good luck in college.
My senior shout out video is for Jared Welch, Nick Wagner, Julian Cordry, and Lethal Lee. I want to thank you guys for being good teammates to me on the tennis team and being good friends. You guys helped me a lot with my tennis game and helped me evolve, and I appreciate that. I want to thank you guys and wish you guys the best of luck outside of high school, and make sure you come back and see me.
My senior shout-out goes to Holly Schultz. Thanks, Holly, for being a great friend over the years and giving great advice. We're going to miss you next year in orchestra, and have fun in Mizzou.
My senior shout-out goes out to Tori Zorch. I'm going to miss you hitting bombs on the softball team next year, and I wish you luck with everything you do next year at Washburn for softball and everything else that comes up later on in life, and I thank you for being there for me this year and being my friend.
My senior shout-out goes to my best friend, Lexi Pardee. Lexi, I love you so much, and I'm so grateful that I get to have you in my life. Good luck in college.
My senior shout-out goes to Matt Rosebrough. Thank you for everything you've done for me. I'm really going to miss you. Good luck in college next year, and don't forget about me. I'm Jessica Armstrong, signing off for THS Patriot Vision.
On April 29th, Truman had its annual blood drive. It was a huge success. Many students and teachers were donors for an opportunity to help out the community.
My name is Lexi Pardee. Today I'm running the blood drive at school. Whenever students come in, they check in, and then they'll give their information to a table, and then they fill out a questionnaire, and then they wait. And when they go to the table, when they're done, we have snacks waiting for them and shirts and stickers to say that they donated.
Hi, I'm Eric Reyes. I feel really good about being in the blood drive because I get to help everybody that does donate, and it's really cool. And hopefully, I mean, potentially save somebody's life.
Hi, my name is Amy. I wanted to give blood because it seemed like an easy way and a free way to help out people in my community. I was kind of unsure of why I even signed up, but it was worth it.
My name is Adrian Gately. I'm a technical trainer with the Community Blood Center. What I do is basically teach our new employees how to do phlebotomy and the donor interviews. What we do is extremely important to make sure that that the Kansas City area hospitals have enough blood to save lives. People should donate for people like me because, you know, not only am I a donor, but in the past I was a blood recipient. If you've had a family member or a loved one or just somebody you know at the office or somebody you know at church that's been in the hospital and had to receive blood components, you should donate if you're able to.
I'm Kirsten Payne.
I'm Raquel Smith.
I'm Kylie White.
And we're signing off for Patriot Vision.
And that concludes Patriot Vision for the year.
Have a great summer.